We are back to our topic future tense. Again, I'll just tell you the forms. First form is simple future, second future continuous, and third is future perfect. So we are on our third part, that is future perfect tense. When it is used, why it is used? It is used to denote an action in the future. But before that action, there is another action, just to denote that type of actions. So our future perfect tense is used. So we'll come to the structure. Just see what is the structure. Subject plus will shall plus have plus MV third form plus rest part of sentence. Now what is MV third? MV third form is also known as past participle. Past participle form of verb. So just see, I will make you understand what is past participle. Here I have written two examples. First is by. By is first form of verb. Okay. Next, second form of by is bought. Third form of by is say bought. And fourth form, can you tell me? I don't have any idea, but the fourth form is what? By ing form of the verb. So here also, next is go, second form is went, third form is gone, and the fourth form is ing form of verb, that is going. So I hope you might have understood about this. Fourth form I have not written because here the space is less. So just see, example, Manish will have left by 9 o'clock. Here Manish is our subject, will is used according to our subject because it is singular, we are using will. Actually shall has been disappearing from our modern English grammar. So most of the time we use will in our future tense. So with will we use have. Have is used to denote future perfect tense, and third form of verb, that is left. Example, next example, Rohit will have cleaned the room by the evening. Same here also, Rohit is your subject. Rohit is your subject. Will we are using according to Rohit because Rohit is singular. So will we are using according to it. Have is used for perfect tense, and clean is the third form of verb.